So yes or no, sir, should we start? Mean, so statistics. The chapter what we are studying now, it is statistics. So in statistics actually what is there? The meaning of statistics is collecting many observations. Collecting many observations. Observations means what? Data. Data. Okay. So there will be a collection of data. Many more data will be there. Now with that data, we want to find out that what will be the average value of that data. Okay. How many data are more in number? Correct or not? How many data are less in number? Correct? Okay, so in between what will be the data that will be given by mean? How many more data are there that will be giving? Mode. That will be giving mode. Okay. So middle value of all the data, middle value if you want to find out, that will be given by median. That will be given by median. Okay. So mean, median, mode is important part of this statistics. So we discussed about mean in our last class, and in that mean we discussed about that how to find mean by using direct method. Correct. So one was direct method. So in that what we did, we found mean of number of data. So what we did, we added all the data together and divided by n number of data, correct or not? So when we divided, when we added all the data and we divided it by number of data.
Yes sir.
Number of data, it may be 10, it may be 12. Then we found this x mean. That was the direct method. Okay, so when the data was given to you only in one number. But if suppose data is given in intervals, if the data was given in intervals, correct?
Yes sir.
Then in intervals what it was there? So it was only group data, then in intervals. So in intervals, you were given a certain interval, x to y, like this, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, 0 to 15, like this. So in that interval, what we were doing? The very first thing, we were adding both of the interval and divided by 2. So this is what? Lower class mark.
Yes, sir.
This is higher class mark. So when class interval was given and frequency was given, so our formula became little different. So what? So sigma I is equal to 1 to n f I x I, correct?
Yes sir.
By sigma I is equal to 1 to n f I is the frequency. So this was given you class interval, and in that class interval we were finding first by adding lower class mark plus upper class mark divided by 2. That was becoming xi, correct or not?
Yes sir.
That was only xi. So we solved that type of question also. So this was called direct method. Now if more you can say complex data or higher value is given to you, then multiplication and other things, addition will become more difficult. Okay, so then another method was found to find that mean, and that is called assumed mean. Assumed
mean.
Okay, what we are going to discuss now. Correct? Then third one, that is called step deviation method. Step
deviation method.
Deviation method of finding mean. Step deviation method of finding mean. So these two are very much important. Once we will be understanding this assumed mean, then we will go for understanding the step deviation mean, step by step. Okay? And here, we will be studying, you can say, by utilizing one example. By solving one example, we will be understanding that what actually assumed mean method, what actually step deviation method. Okay, so in assumed mean method, what it is there, the formula says that x mean, we assumed any mean A. We assumed any mean A. Okay, and then we went for again sigma I is equal to 1 to n fi and some ui divided by again I is equal to 1 to n fi, where ui was xi minus a. Save all that assumed mean.
Okay,
so in between the data we assume let this may be the mean and we will be utilizing this formula.
Okay.
In step deviation method what is there? In step deviation method again that mean will be found by using class interval. Means what is the interval between that class? Whether 5 difference is there, like 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, here difference is
5
only. So that 5 also will be utilized here. So how it will be? So it will be assumed mean plus sigma I is equal to 1 to n fi some ti, correct?
Yes, sir.
And sigma I is equal to 1 to n fi, where we add into h. H is what? That class interval. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Where di is equal to xi minus a by h. Correct?
No.
Earlier it was ui was xy minus a. When you have done this xi minus a by h, in that case h will get multiplied here and the formula will get modified.
What is step deviation method that h has?
In step deviation method h will be coming. In assumed mean method, this method will be utilized. Okay? Right. So this formula you can note it down. Then we will solve one question and then you will see. Okay. Right. So for direct you have already written?
Yes, sir.
Hmm. Now. So here we are having question number 4, we will solve question number 4 or we will solve question number 5 where high number is there. Question number 5, no problem. Right. So question number 5 we will do. And in question number 5, let us do by all the methods. All the methods, and let us see that with all the methods,
the answer was the
same answer is coming or not. See, one example will be enough to understand. Correct or not? Okay. So that we will be doing. Can I hear this one?
Once again, sir.
Okay. So question number 5 says that in a retail market, fruit vendors were selling mangoes kept in packing boxes. Now these boxes contain varying number of mangoes, right? The following was the distribution of mangoes according to the number of boxes. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Right. No problem. Let us take it, this question number 4 itself first, then we will go for 5. Because all the methods will be applied, na?
Yes, sir.
So we will be going for so that 30 women were examined in a hospital. Can I have it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that I can write the data also simultaneously. Because writing data in a tabular form is the very first work is to be done here in statistics. So 30 women were examined in a hospital by a doctor, and the number of heartbeats per minute were recorded and summarized as follows. Okay, now find the mean heartbeats per minute for these women choosing the suitable method. So it is telling that you yourself decide which method you need to choose. Whether you are choosing dash method, whether you are choosing
assumed
mean method,
right,
or whether you are choosing step deviation method, right? So now it is given to us that class interval. First we will be writing class interval.
Yes, sir.
Okay. That class interval, then second one we will be writing fi.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So it is 65 to
68.
68. Then 2.
Yes, sir.
68 to
71.
Okay. 4.
Yes, sir.
Tell me.
71 to 74.
71 to 74.
3.
3.
74 to 77.
Okay.
8. 77 to 80.
80.
7.
7.
80 to 83.
Yes.
4.
Okay.
83 to 86.
Right.
2.
Very good. So this is the data given to us. We need to find. We need to find mean. Okay. Correct or not? Mean heartbeat per minute. Right. So this class interval number of heartbeats we have assigned at 65 to 68. So class interval, it will become class interval. It is frequency. For two women, 65 to 68. For four women, 68 to 71. Like this, is there? Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we need to find xi now.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So xi. So xi. How we are finding? Addition of these two class intervals
divided by 2.
Okay, so in this case what will be there? So 60 plus 60, 120. 120 plus 8, 128. And plus 5, 133.
Yes,
yes or no? So 133 divided by 2 will be 6. Okay, so 6, 12, and then again 13, then again 66.5. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So 66.5. Tell me yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Now this 66.5, once this is matching, okay. Once this 74, 74, 77, 77, it is matching. Okay, same to same it is there. Then what will be doing?
60 plus.
Just add yes. What? Difference between three. These two. 3. Just start adding 3.
69.
So 69.5. Then
72.5.
75.5. 78.5. Okay.
Yes.
And then 81.5. 84.5.
Yes, sir.
Let us have a check. Let us have a check whether we have done correctly or not. Okay. So last one we have a check. So 80 plus 80, 160 and 169. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
By 2. So 28, then 4.5. It means it is correct. It means all our calculation is correct.
Okay.
Okay, so have a check.
Okay.
Understood now?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now this sigma fi. So 4, 2, 6, 3, 9. 9 and 17. 17, 7.
77.
24. 28 and 230. It is given in question itself, it is given that 30 women.
Yes.
30 women. So it will be composed as 30 only. Sigma Fi. So it is sigma Fi. Correct or not? Right. Now, if you are going for direct method first, we will go for direct method first.
Right.
So, direct method if you are going, that is by direct method we will solve, right?
Yes, sir.
Or we will solve direct method at the last. Because already we have seen direct method. Okay. Here we need to see assumed, it is the assumed method and step deviation. Yes. That we will be doing at the last, okay?
Okay.
Right. So let us see here. So assumed mean.
Assumed mean
method. So, from this xi, anyone we will be choosing as assumed mean.
Okay, sir.
Generally, we are going somewhere in the middle. That one we are taking. Okay. But anyone can be taken.
Okay, sir.
But assumed mean, generally, I am telling center. You. Generally, anyone at the in the center we take. Okay. So, tell me which one we will take.
75.5.
Okay, right. Very good. So, as per your wish, now I have marked it as A is equal to 75.5. Right?
Yes, sir.
Now, next one what we will be finding? So, xi minus A. Correct?
Yes.
So, we will be putting it as ui is equal to xi minus A. And A is what? 75.5?
Yes, sir.
So, can I write 75.5 here?
Okay, sir.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
No doubt. Very nice. Good gentleman. So 75.5 minus 66. Sorry. 66.5 minus 76. 75.5. So how much it is giving you? 9.
Yes, sir.
9 or not?
Yes, sir.
9 or minus 9? 66.5, xi is 66.5.
Minus
75.5 is giving you minus 9.
Yes, sir.
Right. Now 69.5. So how much it is giving you?
Minus 6. Sir?
Minus
6.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Tell me. Correct?
Sir, I think 7, sir.
Why? Why 7? See, 0.5, 0.50. Then 75 minus 16? 6 only, sir?
Yes, sir.
Eh?
Yes, sir.
Correct or not? 75 minus 69 is 6 only. You know, column.
Sir,
eh?
It will not come, sir.
See, 75.5 and 69.5, correct? So 0.5, 0.5 minus is 0.
Correct, sir.
Okay, and this is 59, 6, then 6, over 6.0.
Yes,
see, what is the funda here? Funda here, the difference also will come 3 only.
Okay, sir.
Here also 3 was there, na? Here also difference will come 3. Correct? Okay, so this is how easily we will be able to do it. Now, here 72.5, so minus 3.
Yes, sir.
Now 75.5, minus 75.5, 0. Again, it will increase.
3. 6.
6.
9.
See here.
Yes, sir.
Eh?
3.
How nicely it has increased,
yes,
eh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now how nicely you have reduced this bigger number. In direct method, what we will be doing? We will multiply these two. We will multiply these two. And then again you will write. And then again you will add. Correct or not? And then you will be dividing by this 30. Then only we will be getting that one. Here we have reduced this multiplication bigger number. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now ui is this one. So xi minus 75.5. Now what we need to do? We will be finding out fi ui. Fi?
Ui.
Ui means this one into this one. Yes or no?
Yes.
So tell me, what will be?
Minus 18.
Very good. Minus
24.
Minus 24. Very good.
Minus 9.
Minus 9. Very
zero.
Good. Then 0.
21.
24.
Then
24. 18. Then
18.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now what we will be finding out? We will be finding sigma fi ui. Sigma fi ui.
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, our assumed mean method was what? X mean is equal to a plus
fi
ui. Sigma I is equal to 1 to n by sigma fi. Yes or no?
Yes,
okay. So now we will be adding. So this 18 will get cancelled.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This 24 will get cancelled.
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now 21 minus 9. 21
minus
9?
21 minus 9. 1. Sir, 10, 12.
Huh? 12?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so 12 has come?
Yes, sir.
Right? Now let us find out our mean.
Mean.
So x mean is equal to a. A is what?
75.5.
75.5, very good. Plus, correct, sir?
12, yes, sir.
Okay. Sigma fi ui?
12.
Then?
Divide by 30.
30, very nice. So this has, you can say, 3, 4 and 3, 10, correct?
Yes, sir.
So this has given you 75.5 plus 0.4.
Yes, sir.
Then it has become 75.9. So our mean is 75.9. Okay? So just note it down. Then we will solve it by step deviation method.
Okay?
Right, good.